We're not alone.
You're gonna see a whole lot of magic. Look at this trick and that trick. And when he says it's not a lot, you'll agree it's such a lot. Meet the man who is done.
Very good crowd this week. A nice audience. Well, jury, I hope you're going to enjoy yourself because, and the audience going to enjoy themselves as well, because what we have today is the answer to a lot of problems for people. You see, what do we use for power? Gas. We use gas, we use water, we use electricity, and from time to time, for various reasons, they get cooked off. Well, we have a magical solution to your problems. And I'd like to introduce you now, Gwen. Now, Gwen, over here, it looks like a computerized device. It has a molecular structure going round and round on the top there. And here we have a water supply, which is connected around the back there somewhere. And we have a gas supply here, which I hope you can see goes into here and then vanishes within, I suppose. And, and over here we have an electric light bulb, and that goes in there and it's plugged in there. See, so far, nothing rather amazing, is it? But when you have these supplies in, who turns up? The inspectors turn up. That's who turns up. Well, we've got some spectres. I expect you were expecting that. And I need three. So I'll have you and you and the gentleman in the middle of the back there. Yeah, yes, you, yes, with the glasses on. That's really good. Now, if you three guys come over here, come over here. Now, I want you to just line up. You stand there. You come in the middle. That's fine. And you come on this end. There we are. Stroking the back of the head. I love the way you did that. Yeah, it was nice. That really. Your name?
Stanley.
Stanley?
Ashbridge.
Ashbridge. That's right. I'll never remember it. I might call you Stanley. And you are?
Suresh.
Of course you are. And, Suresh. He sure is Suresh. Okay. And you are?
Stephen.
Yeah. Say, why don't you call yourself Steve, say? Easy. Okay. Suresh. And, yes. Now, this is to remind me that we're going to make you all into various inspectors of different boards. Now, of course, Stephen, there you go. You are going to be a waterboard inspector, so you need a hat that's appropriate. So you put that on. They go the other way around, Stephen. What do you really do for a living, Stephen?
I don't know, well, I should tell you, police officer.
You're a police officer? Oh, well, it counts for the lot. There we are. And a gas board man. Now, Suresh, we're going to make you a gas board man and give you an appropriate piece of equipment to wear. Have you ever seen one of those?
Never seen before.
You've never seen before?
No.
Oh. Pardon?
On television, yes.
You've seen it on television? Okay, well, don't put it on backwards or you will look very silly. Sillier than our policeman friend there. But he's now a waterboard inspector, all right? Obviously expecting a leak. And Suresh is attempting to put on a gas mask, which he has never seen before. Very good. Hey, yeah. That's really good. Are you all right in there?
Yes, I am.
You can see me?
I can't see.
Can you speak up, please?
I can see you.
Oh, good. Right, that's it. Would you let me know if he starts falling over? Right. Now, and for the electricity board, man, I want you to imagine you've been the electricity board. I think this is funny now I've looked at you. But what you do is you put this on. Now, this is... yes, you put that on. I think the...
That's the back, isn't it?
That's the back. An intelligent lad over here, Stanley. Right. You're a Yorkshireman, are you?
Oh, yes.
Oh, great. That's it. Okay. Right now, then. You put that on there. You see, it's just like you've had a shock in electric blue. Now, you two guys come over here while I expect to explain to... No, two guys, you see. Two. Yeah. Two. Oh, I bet my car's covered in tickets when I get out of here. Now, what's... come over here, Ossifer, and inspect the premises. Now, what we have here is this water supply going into the tap, out of the tap. You understand that?
Yes.
See? Now, what we do is we get the inspector to come along and he cuts off the water supply, you see? And they do that like that, you see? See? And when they cut that off, I want you now to just hold that there, like that, you see? Now, you hold that like that, and the water, you may have noticed, although with you I'm not so sure, it's still flowing, all right? The water is still running. Don't move. You just stay there. Now, let's go around here. Now, here we have a gas supply to a Bunsen burner. Now, I'm going to disconnect this. I don't know what Gwen thinks of that. Right. Now, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Oh, yes, of course. Sorry. your ears are still sticking out. Now, come here, hashish. No, sureish. You hold that and you squeeze it like that, all right? Mm. And you just keep that there. Yeah. And you will notice the gas is still burning.
It is.
Yes, it is. Yes. Now then, Toya Wilcox, I'll tell you what we'll do. Come here, Stanley. Now, Stanley, what I want you to do is very carefully, I'm going to let you do this because it's dangerous. I want you to... Yes, it's all right. What do you do normally for a living?
Little as possible.
As little as possible? All right. Well, you're going to do a little more, okay? I want you to unplug the plug. Now, you unplug that, and look, although the plug is not in there at all... What do you mean, what do we do now? That's another fine mess you've got me into, Stanley. Well, nevertheless, although this is clear perspex here, and all the way around it, the thing is still lit, is it not?
It is.
It is. Now then, let us consider what we have here. Gwen, gas, water, and electricity from nowhere. If I take this, just step back a moment while we see the policeman's water still running. Thank you. If you just... Yes. Now, did you have anything to eat or drink before you came on the show?
No, I had some beer.
You had some beer?
Yes.
That's why it's still running. Come here. Hold that. Thank you, Shoreish. Right. Did you have anything to eat before
yes.
you came on the show?
Yes, I did.
What did you have?
A current bun.
Current bun?
Uh-huh.
It's where electricity comes from, currents. That's why you got that, okay? And in truth, we gave you something to eat before you came on the show as well. Is this okay? You can ease this up to talk to me. It's okay. Okay. What did you have to
baked beans.
Baked beans? Oh, wow! Once again, we are under laboratory conditions. In other words, being watched very closely to make sure that there is no jiggery-pokery or anything in what we do. You see, here, we ask a member of the jury to sit closely. We invite you to watch closely as well on camera. And we try to do the absolutely impossible. Now, for example, a little pile here of torn-up playing cards, and they've been torn up by members of the jury. Did you get involved in this? And your name is Jane, and yes. you're from near Herne Hill.
Yes.
Yeah? Would you like to say hello to the little camera there? Do the little wave, then your friends will know it really is you. And what you were doing, or what all of you were doing, were you folding playing cards in half, I think.
Yes.
Something like that. I don't know. Maybe one of the two of you just ripped the middle out. But I tear it in half, and then I do this. And this is really just to show the people at home the sort of thing that has been going on. Because we already have a pile of them torn out, but I just want them to know exactly what it is. The middle's not important. We get rid of that. If we unfold this like that and go all the way around it to square it all up, like this. I don't know whether you did that. But then this particular one, I'm going to fold it in half, like so, and I'm going to just open it up a bit and stand it on the table. All right? Now, that's frame number one. Now, I admit I handled that and I tore that, but I did it in such a way I don't think anyone would accuse me of any jiggery-pokery. Now, if we can just take these all off here, if we just take them all off there, like this, and we just take one. Doesn't matter which one. We'll have that one. And lose those. Now, we'll leave the tabletop nice and clear now because, as you can see, this one, which is the 10 of diamonds, if I go all the way around it like this and just square it all off again, get it really tight and nice and straight, this would not impress you if I did this. Watch. If I put that through there, yes, and folded it over like so, that wouldn't impress you because, obviously, I folded it around and therefore it's going to stay hooked on. Yep. Okay. Now, if I unfolded it and did it the other way on, it wouldn't impress you because, obviously, then, it would be an easy matter to pull it off. In other words, matter would not go through matter. And that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to make solid matter go through solid matter. What I want you to do is just point a finger forwards at me. That's it, nice and high. And I'll unfold the bits and I'll just put it on your finger, all right? Again, just unfold it like that, okay? And we've got two like that, and we just get, oh, I tell you what, we'll put both holes through like that. Now, there they are through there. Now we need a pair of tweezers, because under laboratory conditions, we work clinically. Watch. 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 Now, we now have two frames linked together, and they're not only linked together, but what I want you to do is you take them yourself,
Look at them very, very closely. There are no tears. There are no joints. There's nothing untoward about that at all, is there? In other words, one has gone right through the other under laboratory conditions.
Say that sometimes we have acts on our show that are absolutely amazing, and sometimes we have acts on our show that are absolutely charming, and sometimes we have acts that combine both of those to different degrees. See, and this next act is beautifully charming. It's a mixture of magic and mime. From the United States, it's my pleasure to introduce Tina Lenert. Thank you. question in all sincerity, why are you gathered here today at the Ballyhoo Corner? I'll tell you why. Because behind this curtain here, we have got the most unbelievable item this week. The most unbelievable item. Would you believe a man-eating tiger behind there? And completely without the aid of bars, we shall reveal him to you later. In the meantime, however, I have a little mystery which I would like to show you, involving the use of three of these. Now, these three are, as you can see, ordinary cards. Ordinary cards, my guy. And I'm going to put them back, one, two, three of them. Yep, we've got three there. As a matter of fact, we've got another three ordinary cards here. Have we not? Yes, we have. I'll put them there. We have got another three ordinary cards. Yeah. Count them yourself. And we have got here another three. And what are they, sir? They are ordinary cards. You're absolutely right, so to think. All right? Now then, if I leave them on display, I should like to show you what else I'm going to use. First of all, I'm going to use this one. This is the heist of diamonds. I'm going to use this one. This is the heist of clubs. I'm going to use this one. This is the ice of hearts. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, they only have a heist, the heist of spades. So now we have got three ordinary cards and four heists. So, a number between one and four?
Three.
Okay. Un, deux, three. I only went for 2 weeks. Now, this is important. If we take these heists of hearts and the three ordinary cards, and we place them into this envelope what we have got here, I hope you can see them going in there, and we just turn it round and leave it on display here, we have one heist and three ordinary cards. Here, I have another one. And if I take this one, which is the heist of diamonds, and we turn it face down, then we take the bottom one out. What is it? It's the Queen of Hearts. I shall put it here. Get rid. Here is a 10 of clubs. I shall put that down here as well. Get rid. Here is a 9 of clubs. And here, would you believe, the heist has gone. Well. No applause necessary. I shall do it again. Here we have the ice of clubs. Now, the ice of clubs, I'm going to do the same as I did with the previous heist. I'm going to turn it face down. And I'm going to take one out of the back, the Queen of Diamonds, a ordinary card. I'm going to take this one, the 8 of Spades, a ordinary card. I'm going to take this one, the 10 of Spades, a ordinary card. And finally, the heist has gone. It's amazing. Here, we have the final heist, excluding, of course, the heist what is already in the envelope. So, we turn the heist of spades face down. From the behind, we take the King of Clubs, a ordinary card. We take this one, the 7 of diamonds, another ordinary card. And finally, this one, the 8 of diamonds, a ordinary card. Leaving here, the ice. No, it has gone. So, where could they be? Where could they be? Let us have a look in the envelope, where we do truly find the four heists. Heist, which is a chalk heist. We have got a strawberry heist. We've got a vanilla heist. And would you believe it? A raspberry ripple. Let me explain to you now what is going to happen. Behind here, we have got, I promised you, a man-eating tiger. Okay. When these curtains are open, this man-eating tiger will be revealed to you without the aid of any bars. Only my whip will prevent the attack. Ladies and gentlemen, a man-eating tiger. There's a man-eating tiger. I'm not into that. And what is going to happen now is not a joke. In fact, a couple of our jury have been examining the properties that we're going to use in the next act because they really are very, very heavy. You've got to believe that at home, but they really are very heavy. Our next act is not a weightlifter. He is a heavyweight juggler. As far as I know, probably the only one in the world. And I'd like to give an enormous round of applause here to Markus.
Thank you.
That torpedo weighed 108 pounds. In this feat, Markus will attempt to catch a missile weighing 130 pounds, hurtling through the air onto the back of his neck. I repeat, 130 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Markus.
Those things really were incredibly heavy. Now, behind me, Debbie, the famous Debbie McGee, folks, is collecting money from our jury. And don't think that's easy. She's collecting paper money. We ask them to fold it up small, and we make a donation to the plate. Is that all we've got tonight? Now, the reason is that I have to arrive at a random note, okay? Now, obviously, while I'm talking to you, I don't know who's donated what. Now I turn round and see which miserable devil only put a pound in. But somebody put a tenner in, a few fivers, that's good. Now, put your hands up if you donated money. Just put your hands up, please. Thank you. Now, I have to ask you to be honest. I want you to just take back anything that you put on. It may not be the same one, of course. Again, that arrives at a random choice. What did you put on, sweetheart? A pound. I see. Yes. And, tenner? Yes. And, well, you're a handsome fellow. I think what we'll do is we'll wait for you till last. I've got a lot left. Who put some more in? You did? What did you put in?
A fiver.
A fiver? Woo-hoo-hoo! Did you put anything in? No, you wouldn't. Right, that's it. Okay. A dashboard man. Right. There we are. Pound. Oh, it was you with the pound, was it? Right. And hopefully we get the tenner. No, she's taken the tenner. So you donated a fiver. All right? Fine. If you want your money back, sir, just stood up. Stood up. There's your money. Now, follow it. And we'll have a nice round of applause for a volunteer. Right, you can have that. You can open it. Right. Will you come round the back of the table, please? Round the back, because I'm the star and they can't see me. See? Now, I've got a pen out of my pocket, and I have here a plate which we collected the money on. You've got a fiver. Now, it may not have been the five you started off with if you made a note of the number. Therefore, I don't know whether you did. What is the number? Let's have a look. Oh, you put it away again. Oh, no, no. That was not a joke. We are going to use your fiver in a magical experiment. The last three numbers are?
868.
868. Now, what I'm going to do is write those on there to remind ourselves later, lest we forget, because there's quite a little bit to get through with this trick. 868 there. Can I just borrow it just for a second? And now, this is the fiver that you've now just given to me. Now, what I do is I'm going to hold it at arm's length like that and hope that a camera can actually see the tiny little number there. Let's hope it can. Fine. Now, I've got it as steady as I can, you see, when I do that. Have to. And I'm going to put the plate here so that it will constantly remind us. And here we are in a sort of a kitchen-like setting, as it were. And we're going to fold up the fiver again. All right? 868. Fiver. And I'm going to put it inside this envelope. All right? Do you want to check anything?
Check the number.
You just want to check the number?
Yeah.
Slight delay there. You two, an idiot, wanting to check. Sorry, nothing personal. Now, would you just like to lick that and seal it down, because I can't stand the taste of them. Thank you. What do you do for a living, sir?
Communications controller.
A communications controller? In that case, you will know to speak a little louder.
Right.
Thank you. Right. Now, you just hold that, just like that. Don't panic, you'll be all right. Just relax. Communications controller. Now, where did I put the matches? Oh, there they are. Right, now. Just couldn't see them for a minute. Now, we'll only need one of those, and we open the top, and there they are. Now, let's hit that. Here's my little devil, oh yeah, my little devil. Now, we're going to use the match to light the candle like this, you see. That's plan A. And we just put that like that, and we light the candle. Once we've done that, the next thing we do is we take the envelope, but it's not the old gag. You're all right. What we do with this is we hold it in front of the flame and hope that the people at home can see the shape of the money through the envelope. Let's hope you can see that. Can you see that? Good? Yes? Right, there's the money. So, now we've done that. Now, that is a sort of a test so the people at home know that I didn't do the sneaky move before with sneaking it out. A bit of pun there. So, now I want you to just recap just for a moment and imagine what we have done. Here tonight, we have had a £5 note borrowed at random. The £5 note borrowed at random, then what happened after that was we checked the number. The number was then written down on the plate, which is over there. Then you should also remember to blow out the candle. Oh, look, that's on fire. Now here we have a flash in the pan. Sorry. Now, that was ignited by that. What a good idea us having this pan here. Now, you've got to admit that there's not a lot of that left, is there? Not a lot, no. You're happy. What's your first name?
Les.
Les. Well, let's put it in the dustbin. Right. So, you are in the presence, however. Come here. You're in the presence of a magician who can do wondrous magic. Would you like to pick any of these things we have on the table? Bearing in mind your fiver. There's a banana, there's a lemon, there's an onion, there's an egg, or, you have a free choice, of course, or the pumpkin. Which would you like to pick? You want the egg? You have a free choice of any one of them. You can choose if you want them. The banana, the lemon, the onion, or the pumpkin. Pick one now. The onion. The banana, the lemon, or the pumpkin. Pick now. I am not impressed. Oh. You can have a free choice. Anything you like. And that's where we'll start to look. The lemon. Or the pumpkin!
I've got the lemon.
You want half?
Thank you.
tried that completely by random. The damn pumpkin! And that's the one you have to eat.
Just put this over your head.
Thank you. Yeah, put that by your side. You look very good, isn't that? And just come here. Here is the carving knife. And you've got 3 days. No, sorry. Wrong knife. There we are. There we are. And in... got 20 seconds to do what you have to do, starting from now. What the hell are you doing? Have you ever seen a pumpkin before? When one gives you a knife, you do not go burlesque and start like that. Look, what you do... Hold up. Do you remember that? It was a long time ago. Now, what you do is you make one of these. This... is what we expected you to do. You put this over there, and his little eyes light up. Then you use the knife, which you had, made a mess of my pumpkin with. Then you blow out the candle, and you take out the candle, okay? And you put it onto the table, and you cut it in two. And once you have got it cut in two, you then snap it. When you snap it, in there is a piece of paper, all right? Now, what I want you to do is this. I want you to just take out the piece of paper yourself. Take it out. Thank you. I want you to unroll it yourself with your sticky little hands. And once you have done that, you will see the last three numbers on that fiver are 868, the same as that. Okay, in other words, the £5 note that was in the candle standing there all the while time you were ripping apart my pumpkin, all right, had the number 868, which was yours. Well, that's about it for this week. Tune in again next week when you will see more magic.